Hello children, hope you all are fine. What we studied last 3 days? First day we studied the definition of federalism, key features of federalism, two kinds of federations. In the second day we studied what makes India a federal country. Yesterday we studied how is federalism practiced in India. Today we can move to the next topic, that is decentralization in India. What is decentralization? When power is taken away from central and state government and given to local government, it is called decentralization. Power is taken away from central government and state government and given to local government. What is the importance of decentralization? There are a large number of problems, challenges and issues which require local participation to solve it. For example, construction and maintenance of roads, street light facilities, healthcare facilities, etc. Local people have better knowledge of problems in their locality. It also gives an opportunity to people to directly participate in decision-making process. This helps to inculcate a habit of democratic participation, that means active participation in politics. They know how to use money to manage things more efficiently for their local requirements. All these are very important points. Once again, I will repeat, what is the importance of decentralization? There are a large number of problems, challenges and issues which require local participation to solve it. That is the first point. Second one, people have better knowledge of problems in their locality. Third one, it also gives an opportunity to the people to directly participate in decision-making process. Fourth one, this helps to inculcate a habit of democratic participation. Fifth one, they know how to use money to manage things more efficiently for their local requirements. Next topic is, a major step towards decentralization was taken in 1992. The process of decentralization in India and the principal focus is on the 73rd Amendment, which deals with the district, sub-district and village level of institutions in rural areas. So the most important change in decentralization was taken in 1992. What are the changes? First one, now it is mandatory to hold free, fair and regular elections. Before 1992, no regular elections. After 1992, it is mandatory to hold free, fair and regular elections. The second change is, seats are reserved in the elected bodies and the executive heads of these institutions for the scheduled caste, scheduled tribe and other backward class. Before 1992, seats were not reserved for scheduled caste, scheduled tribe and other backward communities. But after 1992, seats are specially reserved for scheduled caste, scheduled tribe and other backward classes. Third change is, one-third of all positions are reserved for women. Before 1992, no reservation for women. But after 1992, one-third of all positions in local area that are specially reserved for women. Fourth one is, the State Election Commission has been created to conduct panchayat and municipal elections. Before 1992, the Chief Election Commissioner of India conducted elections for local areas. But after 1992, a special commission was set up in each and every state called State Election Commission for conducting panchayat and municipal elections. Who is the Chief Election Commissioner of India? Sunil Arora. Who is the present Election Commissioner of Kerala? Do you know? Mr. V. Bhaskaran. And our next point is, the state government have to share some powers and revenue with local government. Before 1992, state government was not ready to share any powers and revenue with local government. But now it is very important that the state government want to share their powers and revenue with local government. These are the changes after 1992. Once again, we can repeat. A major step towards decentralization was taken in 1992. The changes are, first one, now it is mandatory to hold free, fair and regular elections. Second one, seats are reserved for the scheduled caste and scheduled tribe. Third one, 1/3 of all positions are reserved for women. Fourth one, the State Election Commission has been created to conduct panchayat and municipal elections. And the last one, the state government have to share some powers and revenue with the local government. Our next topic is structure of local government. There are two types. One is rural local government and another one is urban local government. Rural local government is popularly known by the name Panchayati Raj. It has three levels. Rural local government has three levels. One is village level, we call Grama Panchayat. Block level, we call Panchayat Samitis. District level, we call Sila Parishad. First, we can study village level, Grama Panchayats. Each village or a group of village has a Grama Panchayat. Each village or a group of village, that depends on the population of that village. The head of a Grama Panchayat is called President or Sarpanch. Head of Grama Panchayat is called President or Sarpanch. They are directly elected by all the adult population living in that ward. It is the decision-making body for the entire village. So, Grama Panchayat, the decision-making body for the village area. Each village or a group of village has a Grama Panchayat and head of Grama Panchayat is Sarpanch. The most important part of Grama Panchayat is Gram Sabha. Panchayat works under the supervision of Gram Sabha. Who are members in Gram Sabha? All the adult citizens living in that village. It has to meet at least twice or thrice in a year to approve the annual budget of the Grama Panchayat and to review the performance of Grama Panchayat. So what are the functions of Grama Sabha? The Panchayat works under the supervision of Gram Sabha. All adult citizens in that village are members of Gram Sabha. It has to meet at least twice or thrice in a year to approve the annual budget of the Grama Panchayat and to review the performance. Next, we can move to block level. We call Panchayat Samitis. A few Grama Panchayats are grouped together to form block Panchayat. What we studied in the case of village level Gram Panchayat, you know, each village or a group of village has a Grama Panchayat. In the case of block level, we call it as Panchayat Samitis. There, few Grama Panchayats are grouped together to form block Panchayats. The members of this body are elected by all the Panchayat members. Panchayat members are elected the members of Panchayat Samiti. Next, we can move to district level or Zila Parishad. All the Panchayat Samitis together in a district form the Zila Parishad. So we can say this is the apex body of rural local government. District level or Zila Parishad, that is the apex body of rural local government. The members of Zila Parishad are elected and it is headed by a chairperson. These are the points in district panchayat or Zila Parishad. Next one is urban local government. Urban local government consists of municipalities and municipal corporations. Municipalities set up in towns and municipal corporation for cities. The municipalities and corporations are controlled by elected bodies known as councillor. Councillor, that term is familiar for you because in our area, we are electing some representatives. We call that representative as councillor, local representative. Municipal chairperson is the political head of municipality and mayor is the head of municipal corporation. Who is the present mayor of Trivandrum Corporation? Mr. Sri Kumar. So urban local government, you know, it consists of municipalities and municipal corporation. Municipalities set up in towns and municipal corporation for cities. And municipalities are headed by chairperson and mayor is the head of municipal corporation. Next one is, what are the difficulties faced by local government? Actually, elections are held regularly and enthusiastically, but Gram Sabhas are not held regularly. That is one of the difficulty faced by local government. Second one is, most state governments have not transferred significant powers to local government. Most important powers that are not transferred to local government. That is another difficulty faced by local government. The third one is inadequate resources, because they are not getting adequate resources for meeting their needs. What we studied today? Today we studied decentralization. First of all, we studied what is decentralization. Then we studied the importance of decentralization. Then we studied changes after 1992 in the case of local self-governments. And then we studied the structure of local government. And last one, we studied difficulties faced by local government. Now we can move to homework questions. Explain the basic concept of decentralization. When power is taken away from central and state government and given to local government, it is called decentralization. The answer is there. You can write, read textbook and find out its answer. List out any five important points of decentralization. The first one is, there are a large number of problems, challenges and issues which require local participation to solve it. People have better knowledge of problems in their localities. Third one, it also gives an opportunity to people to directly participate in decision-making process. Fourth one, this helps to inculcate a habit of democratic participation. Fifth one, they know how to use money to manage things more efficiently for their local requirements. Next question. Explain five provisions that have been made towards decentralization in India after the constitutional amendment in 1992. Very important question. Now it is mandatory to hold free and fair elections. Second one, seats are reserved for scheduled caste, scheduled tribe and other backward class. Third one, 1/3 of all positions are reserved for women. Fourth one, the State Election Commission has been created to conduct panchayat and municipal elections. And last one, the state government have to share some powers and revenue with local government. Last question, what are the difficulties faced by the local government? While elections are held regularly and enthusiastically, Gram Sabhas are not held regularly. That is the first difficulty. Second one, most state governments have not transferred significant powers to local government. Third one, inadequate resources. These three are the difficulties faced by local government. The lesson is over. All of you, please read textbook very well and complete your notes and prepare at least 31 mark question from this lesson. We can meet again with another lesson.